Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. So now we are discussing about in the body section, okay, headings, paragraphs and font tags. So the first initially we need to know what is the body section, and followed by heading tags and paragraph tags and font tags simultaneously we need to learn. So body tag, what are the tags or text we are using in the body section will be displayed on the web page. So this HTML tutorial explains how to use the HTML element called the body tag with syntax and examples. The description: the HTML body tag defines the main content of the HTML document or the section of the HTML document that will be directly visible on your web page. This tag is also commonly referred to as body element. So the syntax is starting and ending. In between we need to write the tag. So all attributes available in HTML tag: a link, color of the text for selected hyperlinks, background, image to be used a background, BG color, background color, and link, color of text for unvisited hyperlinks, and on after print, function to call user has printed document, on before print, function to call when user requests a document to be printed, on before unload, function to call when document is to be unloaded. So on blur, function to call when document has lost focus, on error, function to call when document fails, on focus, function to call when document has focus, on has changed, function to call when fragment identifier portion of document's address has changed, onload, function to call when document has reloaded, on message, function to call when the document received a message, on offline, function to call when network communication fails, on online, function to call when network communication has restored, and on pop state, function to call when user navigated session history, on redo, function to call when user moved forward in undo history, on resize, function to call when document was resized, on storage, function to call when storage area changed, on undo, function to call when user moved backward in undo history, on unload, function to call when document is being unloaded, text, foreground color of text, vlink, color of text for visited hyperlinks. So browser compatibility: the body tag has basic support with the following browsers: Chrome, Android, Firefox, Firefox Mobile, Internet Explorer, Edge Mobile, Opera, Opera Mobile, Safari, Safari Mobile. These are the most compatible things. So now we move to head section, heading tags. HTML defines 6 levels of headings from H1 to H6. So a heading element implies all the font changes, paragraph breaks before and after, and any white space necessary to render the heading. The head elements are H1, H2, H3, H4, H5 and H6, with H1 being the highest or most important level and H6 is the least important, least size. So H1 heading creates heading level of 1 and 24 points type and large. H2 is 18 point and H3 is 14, H4 is 12, H5 is 10 and H6 is 8. Note, a line space automatically is inserted before and after the heading. So when we write an HTML tag, so starts with HTML and followed by end with HTML. Similarly, head section is started and head section and ended. In between we only write title tag, that HTML headings. In the body section, we are applying the heading tags from H1 to H6. So here the output is generated, H1 is the biggest and H6 is smallest font. Now paragraph tag. When creating an HTML document, you must use tags to specify where you want each paragraph to begin. The opening tag for a paragraph is p tag and the closing is slash p. You do not always need to put a slash p, but it is recommended, especially when a passage has ended. The paragraph code p in HTML automatically creates an extra space between lines, graphics and the text. When you use the p, it is similar to double spacing in a Word document. Without the p, you would not be able to start a new paragraph. The enter key on your keyboard is not recognized in HTML and your sentences will just continue and word wrap. So the main textual blocks are delimited by the paragraph tag starting and ending. Manual line break. Occasionally you need to break a text line permutually using break tag br this like this or this, we can handle. These are called non-pair tags. Horizontal ruler means it gives one line to the entire page. Horizontal ruler appears as lines across the user agent screen and they are generally used to separate information usually by horizontal ruler HR or HR tag. So here simply we are writing it. So paragraph, I am using break and break HR. So the text followed by break, text followed by break, text followed by horizontal ruler. And the next one is a font tag. The font tag used to be the predominant way to control the text within documents. So font, next is face and size and color, and followed by text we need to place. Automatically the text will be displayed, but this tag is removed in HTML5. So it supports inline text attributes. One is CIT, seat, citation, code, DFN, EM, KBD means keyboard text, SAMP means sample computer text code, strongly emphasized also called as bold, DL means delete the text, INS means insert, VAR means variable, B means bold, I means italic, U means underscore, SUP means superscript, SUB means subscript, big means bigger text, small means smaller text, ABBR means abbreviation. Means these tags are helpful in how a text, we need to prepare a HTML document, how a textbook is look like. So here superscript and subscript are special tags. Means superscript means x square, the two in the upper stage will come by superscript. Similarly subscript means h2o, two is in the subscript. So we can write like this with the help of superscript and subscript. And I will also explain insert and delete. So simple, I will tell you a small example related to that. Your manager assigned give a draft to prepare a documentation. After you prepared, you send to the your manager that I prepared the document. After he is searching it, somewhere we find the mistake, then the text will be cancelled by delete and it replaces with a correct text, that is with the help of insert. So here this is the example and the output will be generated. These what are the examples I shown here will be explained in the through program in the next presentation.